SE Cupp, host of SE Cupp Unfiltered, and CNN political commentator Keith Boykin, a former White House aide for President Clinton. So, Keith, I'll start with you. Sanders, again, delivering his speech today, this rally in Brooklyn, not Vermont. He also coming out in a very personal way, sharing some of his background, giving a nod to his immigrant heritage, his father, where he was from, his family. And I'm curious if he's taking this direction because this is what he would need to get beyond his base that obviously didn't land him in the White House in 2016.
Well, I think it's important to distinguish himself first against Donald Trump, who inherited $413 billion from his father, and himself, who had a working class upbringing. And secondly, it is important for him to pivot beyond where he was in the 2016 campaign. In 2016, he was an insurgent. He wasn't the front runner. Hillary Clinton was sort of the established candidate. Now Bernie Sanders is the front runner. He's the one who has the experience, who ran before. He's the one who's expected to do really well. He's doing really well in the polls that came out in New Hampshire.
Yeah.
And so he's got to position himself in a way where he's got to be ready for all the attacks that are going to be coming against him from the left and the right. And he's got to tell a little bit more about his story, who he is, so people understand him not just as this caricature. So I think it was an important statement for him today.
You mentioned that New Hampshire poll, and I want to bring it up for our viewers, too, because that stood out to me earlier this week, where you have Bernie Sanders on top of Joe Biden, even, who's been leading a lot of these polls. Sanders with 26%. The other noteworthy thing there is Elizabeth Warren at 7%. Her numbers are going the wrong direction. In fact, that number's down from where it was in past polling. Yeah. SE, what do you think that's about, and what does she need to do if she wants to turn that around?
Yeah, it's particularly a problem because it's in, you know, neighboring state,
exactly,
New Hampshire, and she has not polled particularly well in her home state among Democrats. Now, you can say, well, you know, she's now running a national election, so that doesn't really matter. But the optics of not doing well where your service record is among your own likely constituents is a problem for her. She's going to have to get around that. Donald Trump, of course, didn't win New York, his home state, but she's a Democrat from a reliably blue state. She has to explain why her progressive record isn't real popular where she's from. And then among Democrats in general, why she's still not managing to catch on. She's got a lot of name ID.
Right.
So that's not the problem here. She's got to convince people, look, no, take a look at me. I'm the choice here.
And I just wonder, too, because after all, in 2016, she had so many people urging her to run.
But she might have missed her moment.
Different. I mean,
that might have been her moment.
Well, I mean, look back at 2012, when Hillary Clinton left the State Department. Her popularity was 60-something percent. Everybody was urging her to run. She was a shoo-in to win the nomination. She was guaranteed to be the president, people were saying. And then she became the victim of excruciating attacks, many of which were unfair. And I think what's happened with Elizabeth Warren is that she has been attacked for this whole Native American story. She hasn't been able to escape it. She's tried
you
to move away from
it. Really,
I honestly think that is really the big issue that has hurt her, because her view haven't changed. Her issues on her progressive record hasn't changed.
So similar to Bernie Sanders, which seems to be working for him.
Well, he has the authenticity that she is criticized for not having, and the Native American debacle really, really hit her hard. I mean, I've called her candidacy DOA because that really negatively defined her. Fairly or not, you know, whatever side you come down on, it really has defined her. And she has not yet been able to get around that as a major, major issue. I'm not sure she can.
I just want to push back on that. Yep. I don't think it's fair to say her candidacy is DOA because of this. This is so early. We haven't had any elections yet. There's not a single primary call because we won't have one for almost another year. There hasn't been a debate.
That's
so
true.
It's true, but these early moments and these early polls, early dollars, that matters. That builds momentum.
I agree, but I completely disagree with her idea that her campaign is
DOA. I don't want to get too hung up on Elizabeth Warren because there's so many more candidates that we can discuss,
right,
including
who
Governor of Washington State, Jay Inslee, who's the latest to join the race. He is going all in on climate change. He says that is going to be the focus of his campaign. Keith, I'll bring this one to you. Do you think a single issue candidate can compete effectively in such a diverse crowd? And just this point in time, in this point in time on the map.
Yes and no. I think it's important to be able to distinguish yourself in this race when there's going to be so many different candidates in there. How does he stand out? By being a single-issue candidate. Amy Klobuchar stood out by being a little bit more conservative than other candidates. Bernie Sanders stands out by being the candidate who talks about economic inequality. You know, Kamala Harris trying to stand out being an African-American candidate. So how do you stand out as a candidate is really important. It's a good idea for him. Whether it's enough to win, I'm not sure. But it does make him distinguishable from 17, 20 other candidates who might be running.
Democrats were obviously a big target of the president's today in his big CPAC speech. We heard from Boris just how long it was. 2+ hours, the longest speech of his presidency. He spent a lot of it railing against the Mueller probe. Do you think, SE, he understands just how serious this investigation is? Not just Mueller's investigation, but the other ones?
I think intuitively and inherently he does, but I also think he's a performer and he knows he needs to perform like everything's fine and everything is not fine. Yeah. But what I saw today, and I watched almost all of the 2-hour speech.
I'm sorry for
you. I know. He needed this. This was a week that really, I think, hit him hard, both on foreign policy and domestic, and he was reveling in this. Yeah. And a couple times, you thought he was done, and he just kept coming back for more because he needed this rally, the adoration. He was in a very friendly room. And so I think putting on this performance, I'm fine, we're great, aren't we in a love affair? I think he needed that, like, for his soul. So I think it wasn't so much an indication of where things really are, but what he needs right
now. He was rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. I mean, we had the Michael Cohen story this week. We had the Jared Kushner story about the security clearance this week. We had the story about Alex Acosta, his labor secretary. We had the failed summit with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. We had the whole issue about the national emergency declaration when Congress has rebuked him on that.
Jared Kushner's security clearance story.
Security clearance, Cohen. It's been a week of disasters for his presidency. And the only thing he can do is get out there and talk to a favorable crowd and let them revel in whatever it is that they want to say. But this whole lock her up chant that was going on today, unbecoming of the president of the United States, in addition to the whole thing, he used a curse word repeatedly, I think more than once at least in his remarks today. What hypocrisy. The GOP was screaming Bloody Mary when Rashida Tlaib used a curse word a few weeks ago. But when the president of the United States goes and does it, it's okay. This is the kind of inconsistency that people are so sick of in politics. They don't like it when people have double standards, and that's exactly what we saw with the president of the United States today.